Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn AE tips, tricks, and shortcuts in less than 7 minutes. No BS, just AE. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to create a realistic looking bouncing ball. I grabbed this image here, and you can get any image. Just something to bounce the ball off of. Add a new shape layer. Add an ellipse. Give that ellipse a fill. Change this just slightly, kind of give it a darker red. Now you can make this ball whatever size you want. Okay, and this is my logo for Millennia Media. It's a new video production company I've just started. Okay, so I'm going to just parent this logo to this red ball here. I'm gonna make this a little bit smaller. Now, if you want this ball to rotate, you want your anchor point to be in the middle. I don't want it to rotate. I want to move it to the bottom. Now, this is a plugin I've used several times in my tutorials, and I will put another link to this in the comment section, this move anchor point. So if you click right here in the middle, the bottom, see our anchor point goes right there to the bottom. And the reason why I want to do that is because as this ball bounces, I'm going to be affecting the scale of the ball, where it's going to compress and expand. And I want it to compress down from the base. So we'll start up kind of high. Move forward about 2 seconds, and then let's have it bounce right here. Want to come back up, come down here. Let's go up a little bit high here. Let's see what we can bounce off of. We'll bounce off of this, top of this right here, and we bounce over this building. Clip the top of that one. Our last one will kind of come right maybe on the corner of this, so that way kind of flies off screen like that. All of your keyframes at the bounce point need to stay linear, okay? So all the ones that are at the height of the bounce need to be bezier. So we can highlight this, and if you hold down the control button, you can just highlight every other keyframe like this. Hit F9. Let's go into our graph editor. So what I want to do, you want the speed to come in like this for all of these bounces. So you want to spread all of these out here. So grab this, pull these over. That way it comes in slow and then goes out fast. Okay, so now if you highlight this keyframe here, in order to give it handles, hit Control, Alt, and click. And then see, that gives us these handles right here. Control, Alt, click. Control, Alt, click. Control, Alt, click. Like I said, we will be tweaking these keyframes as we go. The main thing is just to kind of figure out like how many bounces you want to have. Control, Alt, click for this last one. If you grab all of these keyframes, hold down the Alt key, and drag the last one in, see, it keeps the relative space in between the keyframes, then release Alt and just drag this first one over. Okay, so this is, you know, clearly not exactly what we want, but you kind of get the idea of how this is gonna work. So maybe make 15 keyframes between each one of these keyframes. You do want it to come up slower and then fall faster. So there's gonna be that kind of a shape to your handles. Let's right click on this keyframe, keyframe velocity. What we have here is our incoming velocity and outgoing velocity. And we have our speed and we have influence. For the speed for the incoming, let's set it to 350. Outgoing speed, we'll set to 70. We'll leave our influence for incoming at 100% and outgoing at 20%. So now we kind of have more of that realistic where it's not just kind of hanging in the sky. So right click on this, keyframe velocity. Let's go 350, 70, and 20%. Leave our incoming velocity at 100%. 350, 70, and 20%. Now we don't need to worry about this outgoing keyframe here or this incoming keyframe there. It's just mainly these in the middle. So let's Control Alt click this to get that handle. This distance between these keyframes, you know, will alter depending on how high the bounce is, or, you know, like when it hits this building right here, the time between these two keyframes needs to be a lot shorter than, say, the time between this keyframe and this one. Whenever it lands, I want to scrunch it down. So let's take off this link here and let's move this down to 50%. I'm going to add a keyframe there. And now the next keyframe, you want it to be at the highest point. So not necessarily at the next keyframe, because see, our next keyframe is right here, but because of the speed that we have, it's not at the highest point. Let's go maybe 120. The lowest point is on a linear keyframe, so we can just copy and paste this scale. So Control C for this keyframe, and it's going to paste wherever your playhead is. Control V, use the arrows to move forward keyframes to that one. Control V, Control V, Control V. This is our stretched keyframe at 120. Let's Control C and copy that. And again, you want to wait till you come to the highest point right there. Control V, come down and come back up. Again, our highest point is right there. Your scale will never be 100%. Your ball will constantly be moving between 100, 120, and 150. Now, it's really important when the ball lands, it needs to be directly on top of one of these buildings. So zoom in really close, and then let's just kind of inch it up with the arrow key just to get it to land right there. And see, the reason why, again, I put the anchor point at the bottom is because it's expanding and compressing from the bottom of the ball, because as it lands, you know, and it kind of has that, throws itself back up. Let me make this ball a little bit smaller. Now, this is going to affect your path a little bit, but it'll be easy to manipulate. Since the logo is parented to the shape layer, it will only be affected if you affect your transform properties. So anything you do in your contents will not affect anything parented to it. So let me make this smaller. Let me make that smaller. Click on position. What this will do is it will uniformly move all of the position keyframes. So let's just fix this first landing keyframe here to make sure it's on the top of the building. Instead of 50, let's go 75. Copy, Control C, skip two keyframes, Control V, skip through two keyframes, Control V, like that. If this goes too fast for your taste, you can grab all of these, hold down the Alt key, and just pull them out. And so there is our bouncing ball. And we'll see you next time. I hope this helped you out. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Let me know in the comments below if there's anything you'd like to see and if this episode was helpful. Thanks, everybody. See you next time.